So hi everyone, a very good afternoon. Thank you to the FYERS team for making me live for FYERS API Bridge. The topic for today's session is kickstarting profitable algos. And what we attempt to cover in today's session is first to find and compare among, you know, thousands of strategies that are already available on TradingView. Okay, and we'll see how to customize strategies without any coding. We will also see how to start automated trading with FYERS and what the special benefits FYERS has for algo traders. We'll pick up a lot of Q&A all through this session, right? And we'll also, you know, draw comparison between different software applications. So I've specifically chosen. Thank you. Hi, everyone. So I've specifically chosen, you know, to do this webinar in live marketer so that, you know, I can show you orders being placed live, how, you know, things in real action rather than just something like a demo. Here's a little brief about my background. So I've been passionate. I've been working around algos since last 14 years. I used MetaStock in 2006 and started using ME Broker since 2007. I'm still using it. So if someone asks me among all plethoras of platforms available anywhere globally, I prefer ME Broker personally. Okay. Now that's a personal preference. We'll come to that later. I cleared CMT in 2009. I've used MetaTrader, NinjaTrader also, and you know, we are right now using everything, possibly everything under the sun, like Python, C Sharp, TradingView, charting and all. So newcomer versus experience. So, I mean, the first thing is like, I expect a lot of people will be newcomers to algo trading. I mean, I'm not expecting that people will be here, you know, who have multiple years of experience in algo trading. People who are live, can you just please, type in the chat box, like whether you are a newcomer or an experienced. So I'll understand, you know, what sort of audience we have, and I'll pick up the flow accordingly. Just as expected, most people have started typing newcomer. Some people are one. Okay, so we have a few experienced and most of the people newcomer. Okay, thank you. Yeah. So see, we named this section Kickstarting Profitable Algos and specifically picked up TradingView for this session. Okay, even though there are so many things around there's so many things available. Because, you know, for newcomers, TradingView is the easiest platform. TradingView is also globally the most popular platform. TradingView has 10 times users compared to ME Broker or NinjaTrader. Okay. So why TradingView has so many, almost 10x users? Because it's very easy to use. ME Broker, NinjaTrader, MetaTrader, they have steeper learning curve. TradingView is plug and play with beautiful charts. Now see, comparing between two such platforms is like comparing between oranges and apples. Everything has their own strength and weaknesses. But, you know, I mean, there's always some sort of comparison. Even among orange and apple, you know, if someone asks, I want to eat the fruit which is more juicier. So the natural choice will be orange only, not apple. Okay, yeah, so we'll show you, yes, automated trading is definitely available, and we'll show you how to trade automatically in few minutes. So I was telling you about the level of the learning curve between each platform. So ME Broker, NinjaTrader, MetaTrader, they have their own scripting languages. Unless you are familiar with the scripting languages, you cannot you know, start auto trading with these software. Excel, even for Excel also, you need VBA macro code. So if you are not aware, FYERS on FYERS knowledge base, already these different platform integrations, you know, tutorial for them are already available. Excel and Python are mostly for hardcore programmers only. And TradingView is good for first timers. So, MEBroker can be much more powerful than TradingView, but with MEBroker, you need a lot of coding, and with TradingView, you don't need any coding. So, to start auto trading with TradingView, all you have to do is go to TradingView website and open up a chart. I'm opening directly a stock or a chart of SBI. So, that's all. Okay. Now, you know, so we'll start with some strategies. What all, you know, you can see, you can open this directly from TradingView.com homepage also. And this is the second page. Okay, so this is a global platform where you can get charts of almost every instrument, every listed instrument. NSE is there, indexes are there, global indexes are there. Okay, and how it works is, first we'll, okay, so this is based on what are available. And you know, you can trade based on anything that is available on TradingView charts. Okay, now like someone was asking for MCX. So, you know, you can actually open up any chart of crude oil, whether it is traded in India or in NYMEX or anywhere actually. And from that crude oil, you can trade on MCX actually. Okay, so anything which is available on TradingView chart or TradingView Scanner, you can start automated trading. You can configure algos based on that. So we were talking about SBI. So I'll just show you what kind of, you know, indicators, strategies are there. So we can see, you know, a long list of inbuilt indicators are there, right? Then we have public libraries also. So the thing is, like, you know, now the first newcomers always have this question, which strategy to trade? Okay. And you know, you want to trade yourself, you don't want to blindly follow someone. So, you know, you can go to a particular strategy, you can see the kind of reviews, the kind of likes it has. Okay, and based on that, you know, you can select a particular strategy. TradingView even gives, you can find the description of each strategy, you can backtest that, all of that is available. So I'll show you with something common. A lot of people actually in India prefer Supertrend. Even among Supertrend, there are too many Supertrends available. So we'll pick one of them. So this is, by the way, multiple Supertrend that is available. I just put up. Let's remove this also. We'll keep initially with the most simple Supertrend that we can find. So if you want to trade through multiple Supertrend, if you want to trade with a combination of Supertrend plus RSI, Supertrend plus MACD, it is very likely you'll all find it already, you know, that sort kind of combination also you will find already on TradingView. So this one, I'm Okay. So this is one super trend, which among all others, which I think, which I'll find more preferable. I put it in the line chart, buy and sell buttons, colors, precision, inputs. Okay. So I'll just make it a very small period so that we can get quick signals and we, you know, trade more frequently. So for example, 5, put this also 5. Okay. Now, how do we start trading? Now, to trade, you need FYERS API Bridge. Okay. So what is FYERS API Bridge? How to use FYERS API Bridge? For that, information is already there on the FYERS YouTube channel. This video actually, which was released 5 days back. You can see FYERS API Bridge integration with TradingView. So rather than going into making a very detailed product demo, I'll try to, you know, share more of my experiences and knowledges, and I'll try to answer as many of your questions as possible. Because how to integrate the FYERS API Bridge, how to set it up, this information is already available there, right? Now to start trading with FYERS API Bridge, I've set up a chart here. I've set up an indicator on which I want to trade, and I'll need to create alerts. Okay, so I create alert super trend crossing above. Okay, we see that super trend is about to cross up this SBI is about to cross up its super trend. Okay, and we'll put up alert type LE. So LE stands for long entry. Okay, here. And I'll, so, okay, so in SBI, I want to buy with, when Supertrend gives an alert. In API Bridge, I'm defining the quantity. I can define the quantity. Now, API Bridge itself is a very advanced application with too many features. I can trade based on fixed quantity. I can trade based on stop losses. I can trade based on, different risk limits, okay? So here I'm just set up this API Bridge to trade one quantity, fix one quantity whenever there's a signal, buy signal and super trend. Now, other than super trend, okay, now suppose I want to study trend lines. I'm studying based on trend lines. I'm doing some study based on trend lines. I want to sell this whenever there's a trend line break. So this thing is also available. Okay, so I've drawn a trend line here. And I'm putting there when SBI crosses down. Okay, just cross down. I need to put something, cancel this. Let's put it here. Yeah. So when SBI crosses down this trend line, and what it will do is it will give me a short entry SE type of alert. Okay. Okay, done. So we have put up two alerts here. One is based on super trend. One is based on the trend line. Either of them is broken, it will immediately buy 100% automatically. Now I can go for a break. I can leave my screen and, I can focus on other thing. Meanwhile, while it trades based on the condition setup. So let us go through the questions also that are coming. Whether it works with ADX MACD. So, lot of, like I was saying, pre-built, by the way, see, the alert came. Okay. Just as we were talking, the alert came, buy alert has come based on the super trend. And based on buy alert, it immediately placed order. So you see here, I'll try to open the zoom actually. Zoom magnifier, turn magnifier on or off. So I want to show you. The timestamps. We just had our first, So you see the timestamps here. Okay. So at 1360.03.913, it received a signal. Okay. it received a signal from TradingView type LE long entry that was based on the super trend. And at, you know, within 200 milliseconds, okay, 1604, in within 200 milliseconds, we had this order sent to the broker, FYERS, right? Now, so 200 milliseconds were taken, that is like 1/5 of a second, that was the time taken by the application to, you know, parse the signal, okay? Now, what quantity to place order, okay? How to, you know, different those sort of details it took, right? And then, you know, it placed an order and it got a response within 1 second. So 16, I mean, very close to 1 second, actually, not within, but very close to 1 second. So 16:04:122, the order was placed. 16:05:239, the response was received. Okay, now we'll go and see what happened with this order. So we'll go to trade history because it has been traded. So this is the first, it has been traded, trade value it is showing me. At the price it was traded, it is showing me, right? The buy price and all, I can see the details here. So now this is the beauty of, you know, algo trading, you know, rule-based trading. Right, I can set up my conditions and I can, you know, go for breaks. I can focus on my other work and I can focus on analysis. It is not that if I stop watching screen for a moment, you know, I will miss my opportunity. I will never miss any opportunity. Okay. So we'll come back to the questions now. Okay, so Parth is asking how to use previous day high low indicator of TradingView. So like I was saying, you know, almost everything is available, already available. You just try to, you know, find it out. So we'll remove super trend from here. We'll remove that alert also. Trendline alert type still put there. Okay, so when it crosses below the trend line, it will sell. And I'll look for open high low. So mostly that is like open range breakout, ORB. So see, so many open range breakout system, previous day high low also, previous. So see, so many, you know, you can see so many indicators and strategies based on highs. Someone asked for previous day high low, open range breakout immediately came to my mind. It is a very good setup, actually. Most of the time in volatile markets like this, it gives money. So you see this open range breakout, how the strategy works is, I'll put it on 5 minutes first. Yeah. So how this strategy works is, below the you know, break you go short, below the open range break range, below the opening 5 minute range or 15 minute, whatever you are setting up, below that you go short, above that you buy. Okay, and most of the time it is profitable. A very simple strategy, but most of the time it works, and especially it works in volatile markets like current markets. You'll see, by the way, that sell came and it is traded as well. Okay, so I'll go to API Bridge again. I'll just refresh this window. Just 1 second. Order history and yeah. So it is not filtered based on the app. Okay, it is pending. So it didn't show filled. That is why it is not coming in trade history. But this order is pending as a limit order. So, you know, I had put, by the way, you know, I can choose any order type, limit, market, SLL, SLM. I can choose any product type like bracket order, cover order. Okay. And MIS is for intraday for this thing, for FYERS. NRML is for, you know, positional trading. Okay. So I placed a limit order. that, okay, that order was pending. It has just got filled also. We were just, you know, just before few moments before we were seeing that order status was pending. And now it has been filled. Okay. So, and if you're a new user, you want to check everything via FYERS web, you can do that also. We'll check these two orders via FYERS web as well. Sign in. Okay, so we have come to FYERS web and you can see these two orders being there. So, okay, these are the notifications for the two orders. So we can, you know, match the timestamp here versus bridge versus here also. 2047. Okay. So the bridge will show the timestamp from your local computer and the FYERS, you know, web will show, you know, the actual timestamp. But from this, you know, the status and order placed and response received, we can actually see. So here in 1320, 46, 76, you know, the order was placed and it will, the trade happened in a minute actually here. 1321, 43. So all this detail, you know, you can see how the entire auto trading is happening. So coming back to this thing, so I was telling you about that all different kind of strategies are available already on FYERS web. On TradingView, sorry. Okay, this 5 minute open high low. Okay. So sometime it can give you a very huge amount of profits also. And FYERS API Bridge, one important thing before we go to further question answers. Now, FYERS API Bridge also allows multiple level of risk management, which is very essential for trading. Okay, so you can actually set up the maximum intraday profit loss that you will have for each, you know, each position actually. Okay, so whenever, you know, suppose you set up a loss of say 2000 rupees, you don't want to take a loss of more than 2000 rupees on a particular trade. So you can set up that. So whenever the loss, the unrealized MTM reaches more than 2000 rupees. So this API bridge will try to square it off. You can set up the profit target. You can set up the maximum open position. Okay, now strategies can always misfire. Suppose you misconfigure any strategy. It is continuously sending signals. You can set up the, you know, max open position that you will have. Then other than that, there are more risk management like maximum order per minute. You don't want to place more than one order per minute. Okay, you want to do slow and steady trading. Maximum number of trades per day. Suppose you just don't want to take more than 10 number of trades per day, irrespective, you know, whatever is happening in the strategy. And you don't want to trade in more than three symbols. And based on the realized M2M, say you don't want to book, I mean, you don't want, you know, realize MTM when goes, say, less than 10,000, you don't want to stop trading at all. So all these, you know, risk management also you can handle. Then there are, other than the risk management, there are a lot of signals rules for long entry, long exit, short entry, and short exit, like we were doing. Okay, so any sort of strategy misfire that can happen, the API bridge is powerful enough to handle. Right. We'll come again to questions. So with ADX, MHCD, previous day, high, low, most of the things you can get via, you know, the TradingView platform. So MS Kumar is saying, I don't see alert icon in my FYERS web. So, you know, you need to go to the, you need to take up to the original tradingview.com and you please raise, you know, tradingview.com website. From there directly, you need to take up for alerts actually. Mr. Ramar is asking how to trade in futures. So, you know, you can trade on futures based on underlying. Like initially also, I was telling you, anything, you know, any chart which TradingView shows you, you can trade based on that. Okay. So, you can trade for Nifty futures based on the underlying. So, see in FYERS API Bridge, you have a setting called input symbol. Okay. Input symbol, I can put Nifty. And the exchange symbol in exchange, how I want to trade it, I can put up, you know, whatever details I want. So based on input symbol of, say, Nifty, I can trade in future future index for the 26th March futures. Okay. So this is how, you know, based on underlying, I can trade on futures or on options or in MCX also. And all of this is already covered in the FYERS YouTube channel. All of this, you know, how to trade on futures, how to trade in options, all this is already covered in this particular video on the FYERS YouTube channel. Sapan is asking, can it trade after signal candle breakout? Okay. So, you know, this has all these options. One second. Huh? Yeah. So see, when we actually set up an alert, now, for example, this is open range breakout I've just put up. Now, based on any indicator, any price study, when I want to actually create an alert, okay, add alert to ORB. Now, it gives me a lot of options, okay? Crossing up, crossing down is greater than, lesser than, moving up, moving down, moving up percent, okay? So, you know, I can also set up, you know, a trade when, you know, it moves beyond a certain percent of a candle. Or an indicator. Then, so I have these options once per bar close. Okay. So if I want to trade only on candle close, I can choose that. Okay. If I want to trade, if I want to keep this alert open ended, okay, that whenever this condition is met, it should always keep trading there. Okay. So that is available as well in the Pro plan. By the way, TradingView is free. Okay. And there are different subscription plans. So based on, you know, what your requirements are, you can start using TradingView for free or you can choose any particular subscription plans also. So Mr. Naman, I hope I was able to answer your questions. There are too many. The cost for this entire system, I'll just put it here. So what is the cost of this entire system? So TradingView free. Okay, TradingView is TradingView.com. Charts are free, okay, with real-time data. Okay, and it's free. Okay, but what you get in free is one-time alerts. Okay, like I was just setting alert for one time right now, that are free. These trading buttons, you see that, you know, one second. Let's cancel this. Now we have this long entry, long exit, short entry, short exit buttons also. So these are absolutely free. Okay. So trading buttons, one time alerts, these kind of things are on the free version also available. And FYERS API, free. FYERS API bridge. I mean, API is like, it's not a tangible thing. An API is just, you know, API stands for application programming interface. So it's just a set of credentials actually. So API bridge is a front end. So that has a small cost of 500 per month. Okay. Now, so the cost, total cost will come to 500 if someone wants to start with. If you just want to paper trade, you know, the paper trading, you can request the FYERS API bridge also, FYERS team, sorry, to give you FYERS API bridge for paper trading may be given to you absolutely free of cost. So total cost is 500 for all these three things. Now, if you want to go for pro plan, it has some cost. I'm not sure actually. There was on FYERS notice board, there was recently information given for that. Okay, so that is absolutely free. That is so TradingView Pro plan has some cost, but when you go for TradingView Pro Plus plan, then FYERS API bridge becomes free. So overall, the cost that you will get for the system will be anything from, you know, zero to anything from 2000 per month, depending on the requirements that you have. You can also trade based on screeners. Okay, so TradingView has the capacity to screen real time thousands of stocks. You can set up conditions like to buy any stock where RSI is more than 95 in value. Okay. And you can set up trading based on screener also, not just charts. You can set up trading on screeners also. Okay, Swaroop, Mr. Swaroop is asking that my Chrome extension is not green, still gray. Okay, so this Chrome extension that you see right now here, I'll show using a magnifier. So this, you see this Chrome extension right now, it is green. Okay, so how this extension works? So this is the extension which actually, you know, trades through this, it trades, you know, based on the alerts. Now on TradingView official website, this extension is green on the TradingView page. Actually on a live TradingView chart, this section is, extension is green. On any TradingView.com website where, you know, chart is not there, it will be red. On any other website, it will be always be gray. Okay. So this extension works only for TradingView website, where it turns from gray to red. Gray means 100% inactive. It turns from gray to red on a website, TradingView.com website. And when you actually open a chart, okay, and at the same time, when you actually start trading, when you click start trading on this API bridge, see, I have start trading on in my API bridge. So at that time, it turns green. And you can start this also, this API bridge extension, you can start from here also. Okay, so this is already started. So I don't have to start this. This is already started. And, you know, I can specify the stop loss targets, these kind of things also for bracket orders. Okay, so if your this extension is showing green or red, what you need to do is, you need to click start trading in the API bridge. Okay. You open this chart on a new tab and you just start the extension again. Because this extension turns green only when it is able to connect to FYERS API bridge. and it can connect to FYERS API Bridge only when you have allowed start trading. Okay, unless you allow start trading, it cannot connect to FYERS API Bridge. So that is a sequence. So if someone is facing this problem of the icon showing gray or red, okay, you first need to log into FYERS API Bridge. You first need to start trading, and then you turn it from, you know, and then you start the extension. Ms. Sanita is asking, Algo is set for day. I mean, can I decide time period for condition? Yes, of course, you can define time period for your conditions also. Even that option is there in TradingView, and that option is also available in API Bridge also. You can define that you want to trade from, say, 10 a.m. You don't want to place any trade before 10 a.m. You can do that. And you want to do trades only up to 2 p.m. Okay, you don't want to trade after 2 p.m. So you can put these kind of conditions. You can put up a square of time also that you don't want to exit all trades by 3 p.m. Okay, so time-based management is there in API Bridge, and it can be managed via FYERS, via the TradingView website also. Mr. Pavan is asking, do I need premium TradingView account? So like, you know, I was saying, you may need or you may not need depending on what you want. If you want to do trade based on single alerts, like I was placing alert based on a trend line. Okay, if you simply want to trade based on a trend line, these simple strategies are there. You can, you know, use the TradingView.com free version. It will work well for you. If you want to screen hundreds of stocks, if you have a proper strategy set up, then you'll need the professional version. Mr. Sipan is saying, the explanation is asking about the explanation of breakout. So I was talking about the open range breakout strategy. How the open range breakout strategy works is, it, you know, identifies the range of the first 5 minute or the first 15 minute. Okay. And when that range is taken out, when the market goes above that range or below that range, it is considered as a breakout, and trades are placed based on the breakout. Mr. Dinesh is asking, whether, you know, अपने हिसाब से भी हम कोई स्ट्रेटजी बना सकते हैं. तो दिनेश जी, बिल्कुल अपने हिसाब से. आपको मैंने दिखाया, इतना बड़ा लिस्ट है हजारों स्ट्रेटजी का, मैं दिखा ही रहा था. और लगभग ऐसी कोई स्ट्रेटजी नहीं है जो आप इसमें से निकाल नहीं सकते. और अपने हिसाब से आपको बनाना है, एकदम ही कस्टम बनाना है. इसमें से कुछ भी आपको पसंद नहीं आ रहा तो फिर कोडिंग की जरूरत पड़ेगी. ठीक है, अगर बिल्कुल ही स्क्रैच से ऐसा कुछ करना है जो कि यहाँ पे थाउजेंड्स ऑफ स्ट्रेटजीज है, उनसे आपकी रिक्वायरमेंट नहीं हो रही, देन यू विल नीड टू यूज सम कोडिंग. प्रेम कुमार इज आस्किंग, कैन आई प्लेस अलर्ट ऑन कैश एंड सेट बाय सेल ऑन फ्यूचर्स? यस, एग्जैक्टली, दैट इज व्हाट वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट. एंड ऑल, यू नो, ऑल हाउ टू यूज दिस प्रोडक्ट. ओके, सो द प्रोडक्ट स्पेसिफिक ट्रेनिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज अ प्रोडक्ट, FYERS API Bridge product. It's a very good product by FYERS. So that specific training you can find on the, you know, this YouTube channel only, FYERS API Bridge integration with TradingView. So it will show you how to place orders in futures, in options, everything. Okay. So please go to videos, and this particular video is what we are talking again and again. Okay, so FYERS API Bridge integration with TradingView. So, you know, you can always trade based on that. Mr. Shivas is asking, do you have the option of overall max profit? So we have, you know, realized based on the realized M2 mark to market, no profit, overall profit, not overall profit, but overall loss is there. because, you know, typically, I mean, as per the request, you know, people don't like to contain the overall profit. They want to contain the overall loss. So max profit option is there for trade, but max profit option is not there overall. Or overall, only max loss option is there. Mr. Satyanarayan is asking, trading buttons are part of TradingView or API Bridge. They are, yes, they are part of API Bridge. When you install the API Bridge extension, you know, you get them. You can trade on Nifty options. You go through that. I mean, it's more detailed in this particular session. Because of the, you know, limitation of time, I'm just trying to answer overall as many questions as possible based on my years of experience. Okay. And to specifically how to trade in futures and options, you please refer this video. To connect with Excel, you know, to connect with, so, you know, so what we've decided is we'll have a, you know, these webinars, we'll have regular webinars, not just one specific trading session with general answer Q&A. We'll have regular webinars. So, you know, we can have webinars based on for ME broker. Okay. So next webinar can be for ME broker. It can be for Excel. It can be for Ninja Trader. It can be for Python. It can be for anything that you want. So I think we should do a small poll right now. I mean, people who are live, can you please, you know, mention your request? What do you want to see in the next session? Okay, you want to see a particular strategy, you can specify that particular strategy. If you want to learn about a particular platform, you can specify that, you know, platform, how you want to, what do you want in the next webinar. With MetaTrader also we can keep, with MEBroker also we can keep, based on the requests that are coming, you know, we can put them. This FYERS API Bridge is a cheap plugin with ME broker. You know, the cost will be the same. That's all 500 rupees per month. So if you have ME broker, you have data with that. You just have to, you know, the only cost that you'll incur is 500 per month to start trading in ME broker. Most people have asked so far for ME broker only. So as per the request coming up, you know, we can keep the next session for, you know, for every broker or any thing that you want. So there is no additional brokerage for using FYERS API Bridge. Whatever brokerage plan that you're using, you don't have to pay anything extra in brokerage when you actually want to trade using, you know, when you want to do algo trading. So FYERS API link, I think FYERS team, can you please put the link where, you know, where people can sign up, and if you can put the link in the chat box where people can sign up for the FYERS API and API Bridge. So Mr. Govind has asked a very good question. What happens in case of internet failure, power failure? Okay, so see, when there's internet failure, obviously you will not get an alert. Okay, and this FYERS API Bridge, it cannot connect to, you know, your FYERS account if there's an internet failure. Okay, so if you're doing intraday trading, you are very sensitive, you know, about that there should not be any disruption, and you want to, you know, leave it sort of on its own for, you know, few hours. So it is advisable that you go for a VPS. Okay, so if you go to the FYERS API Bridge, you know, help manual. Okay, so how did I open help manual is from here, going to help. Okay, now from help, I went to the last part, resource setting up free Amazon AWS. Now, this shows you how you can set up your own, you know, free Amazon AWS account. You can use the free VPS to run this API bridge, and you don't have to worry about internet failure, power failure, antivirus, anything actually. And the best part is you can actually use it from mobile. Okay. So I'll just see if there's a relevant article in knowledge base also. Okay. So you can, you know, access it from the API Bridge help manual. You can set up your free AWS and you can start trading from mobile. Now, there's just one issue here. That if you're using the free VPS, it has a limitation of 1 GB RAM. So you cannot, you know, open too many charts, too many things on that. You'll have to keep it simple. Or, you know, you can, for a small nominal cost, you can sign up for a 2 GB RAM or 3 GB RAM VPS. And you can manage this entire trading from mobile. You don't have to worry about internet disconnection or anything. Okay, Shivaji is asking, do we have to keep open the chart? Yes, you need to keep open the chart all of the time. This API Bridge is a desktop application. It should be running all of the time. The chart should be running all of the time also. But if you want to trade in multiple stocks, so for example, you want to trade in 10 stocks, okay, and you don't think it's practical to open all 10 charts at the same time. So what you can do is you can trade from FYERS Screener. Okay, using FYERS Screener, you can trade in multiple scripts without opening charts. Mr. Satyaran is asking for target and stop loss. Okay, so for target and stop loss, what you can do is, based on the alert that is happening on the trading view, okay, based on any alert that is coming up on this trading view, you can, you know, you can set up this stop loss and target. Okay, for example, yeah. So 0.5% and you can save the configuration. Now, when that alert comes and you specify LE or SE, long entry or short entry, as the alert type. Okay, so whenever that alert comes, it will, you know, put, it will place a bracket order using the stop loss and target values from, you know, your specified values. Okay, this is one way of placing bracket orders. Okay, and this extension, this panel that you're seeing is a little advanced. Then you know what is available online. So this is actually a specific, you know, you can say a sort of a gift available only to, you know, people who are attending, who are using through this webinar. So very soon what we'll do is we'll give you this folder, okay, which has this TradingView Advanced extension, okay, the advanced extension, which you can use to set up stop loss target for your bracket order or cover order. So based on the alert, for example, if there's an alert in super trend, you can, you know, based on the alert on a super trend, you can place a bracket order with stop loss and target, with your custom stop loss and target defined here. Okay, so this advanced extension we are releasing today. So I hope I've been able to answer you, Mr. Satyanarayan. Yes, we'll giving you advanced extension immediately, okay? So this download link from now will have, you know, the FYERS API Bridge download link from now will have the advanced extension also. So this is the folder that you will get, okay, with the readme, how to instructions, how to, you know, set this up. And, you know, the default one, I think you are already aware of that. The default application does not allow stop loss target, but it has several other features. Screen missing. People are actually Shivam, can you please see? People are actually notifying that the screen is missing. One second. Okay, I'm sorry. Actually, yeah, the screen sharing was stopped accidentally. Sorry about that. The screen should be visible again. Okay, the screen should be visible again to everyone from now. So, yeah. So Dr. Krishna is asking which language used for creating strategies. So, you know, PineScript is used for creating strategies. So PineScript, TradingView has its own language, PineScript, but the FYERS API bridge, it allows everything. It's not just TradingView, it allows every broker, Excel, Python, it allows everything. But wherever you want to have something custom, you'll need to code it. Okay, if you want something custom in Excel, you will need to code. If you want something custom, absolutely custom in TradingView, you will need to code. If you want something which is already available, if you want to just modify that, like, you know, I place this open range breakout strategy, I can actually modify it and use it. Okay, Mr. Brindaban is saying that data is delayed. I don't think data should be delayed in the TradingView free version also. Let us just see. Actually, I'll put up SBI here. And I will also put up SBI on FYERS web. So, you know, we can see SBI live rate coming on FYERS web versus the TradingView website. So it's almost same, actually. I don't see any, there may be a difference maybe of half a second or less. Okay, the SBI is falling very sharply right now. And we can see both charts going down at the same time. Okay, right now it just went down from something like 248 to 246. Now bouncing up. So we can see both actually, you know, both prices are actually very close. This price and this price. Okay. So what we see from this is that the TradingView.com website does not have any noticeable delay. There may be half a second difference, but not more than that. Mr. Anil is asking for PineScript training. Yes, it's available. You just Google it. Okay, just put on Google for PineScript tutorial. Right, and you'll find many. So TradingView has their official PineScript tutorials, and you can find, you know, so if you want to do your custom, you know, you can use
I mean, if you want to do something custom in TradingView, you can always use PineScript. Mr. Kishan is asking, what is the use of trading buttons? Okay, trading buttons are used, you know, in a lot of situations. For example, you buy using an indicator, okay, but you want to exit that, so suppose we sold this using an indicator and you think, you know, that it is showing you decent profit. You don't want to wait for exit signal from the strategy. So there is where, you know, for exit especially, you can use the trading button here. And some people, they do a lot of analysis, so they don't want to move away from the chart. Okay. So that is where, you know, the trading buttons are very useful. Mr. Anil is saying that he has gone through the tutorial but needs someone. Yeah, I think you are talking for PineScript. So, Mr. Anil, there is a channel also on Telegram for PineScript. Okay. You can join that channel also. Mr. Khan is saying data is not matching with your chart. So, first 5 minute candle low. See, Mr. Khan, see, actually these days, there are a lot of, you know, there is very high volatility. Okay. So, especially for these days, you may see, you know, differences in, especially in first candle low, first candle high, you may see differences across different sources. Because the volatility is very high, you know, some ticks, there will be a difference between different data sources itself. And on usual days also, you will see a difference between, you know, intraday high and intraday low between different data sources. And that difference will not be noticeable, but there will be a difference. This is because the data source is different. It's not that, you know, one data is right, one data is wrong. It's how the data is broadcasted via NSE and via .x, via its subsidiary for .x. Okay, so here is that extension. So I was saying that, you know, this is the setup folder you can download from time from now. We'll just put it up shortly. FYERS API Bridge setup. So this has two folders inside. One is the FYERS API Bridge. You can go and log in through the FYERS API Bridge. Also has the TradingView Advanced extension. So this options of stop loss, target, strategy tag, you can trade across different strategies also. For example, you can trade Nifty in 5 minute also, in 15 minute also. Okay. And you don't want to you don't want the positions of Nifty 5 minute to interfere with the positions of Nifty 15 minute. So you can trade same stock in different strategies and you can put up stop loss target. So these are the advanced things available by the extension. So Subha, if you're having issue with the password or anything, you just, raise a support at the rate fires.in, just raise a ticket, it will be resolved. So Mr. Khan is saying if data is not matching, then there will be some discrepancies with indicators. Yes. Okay. So see, I think this is a very important and relevant question for everyone. Okay. See, any two charting software, any two data charting software you pick, you'll always find differences in data. ME Broker versus TradingView, MT4 versus TradingView, Ninja Trader versus TradingView, FYERS Web versus TradingView. You compare any two, charting platform, you will always find there is a difference of data. Okay. That happens. It's not, like I said, it's not that one data is wrong, one data is right. It happens because the data source is different. How, you know, the data is being broadcasted through .x and all. So now the important thing is that whether it interferes with your trading or not, I can tell you with 100% confidence, it does not interfere with your trading.
Okay, based on my experience, one and a half decade of experience in algo trading, what happens is over a period of time, it actually, irons out the differences. Okay, for example, in TradingView, you have a different high based on that the super trend gave you something else today. Okay, tomorrow you will get a different low. Okay, one day the difference will be in high, one day the difference will be in low. So as a probability over over 100 trades or 200 trades, the differences do not actually play with your indicators. The only concern that you should note is that the data should not be delayed. It should not be delayed like say 1 minute. Okay, it should not be delayed by 30 seconds also. The important and serious concern here is that the data should not be delayed. That is first. Second, the data should not have gaps. It should not happen, that this data is coming now, then it stopped coming, then it started coming again, then it stopped coming. So there should not be gaps and there should not be, significant delay in the data. If these two things are taken care, then I don't think, you'll have differences in your algo's performance over a period of 100 or 200 trades. So we'll have to sign out now. We'll have to sign out. We need to close this session. And based on the feedback, most people have requested the next session to be for Emmy Broker. If you have, please keep giving your feedback. You can give your feedback at support@fyers.in also on what do you want in the next session. Okay. So we'll plan next session in the next week. In the next week, we'll have next session. And based on your feedback, we'll continue from there. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for joining. Have a nice day.